Some legends are told, some turn to dust or to gold, but you will remember me. Remember me for centuries. Just one mistake is all it will take.
Remember who you are. Do you remember your YouTube channel? Do you remember the two movies you are going to review in one video before you had a 2-month hiatus? Do you remember me? Hello, YouTubers. I know, I went on quite a big hiatus after my last review, which was for the Child's Play remake and Toy Story 4. Now, for the past few months, you know, it's been quite a few months now since my last video, and I know I'm really sorry about that. It's just, you know, work got in the way, and now I'm taking 2 online classes to finish up Skylines, so I'm technically I'm still in college, but I just need like 5 more units for my college degree. So I'm taking 2 online classes this semester, and I have work at Safeway, and I work almost every day. I only have like 2 or 3 days off at most every week, so I just don't really have that kind of time anymore. But I do want to get back into this, and this is just like a quick little recap of what's been going on with me. And I know it's been a really long time since my last video, so I apologize for that. I do want to try and get back into this. I don't know if I can like promise a video every day, because I just don't, you know, I work almost every day. I only have like I said, I only have like 2 or 3 days off every week from work. So, and now I also have like 2 college classes that I'm taking that are online. So yeah, just a quick recap, but in this video, I am finally going to do my remake review, my Lion King 2019 remake, as well as Spider-Man Far From Home, and just kind of touch upon like what's been going on with the Spider-Man character just a little bit. I don't want to talk about that too much, but there was kind of like a lot of backlash between Sony and Disney about the rights to Spider-Man and like this whole deal. That they did like a renewal deal for Spider-Man to share the character between their two franchises that they're doing, you know, with the MCU and now this Venomverse that they're doing. But like, moving on to my reviews, so the Lion King 2019 remake is definitely like a technological achievement, because what the director Jon Favreau did with the Jungle Book remake a few years back is what he did with this movie, where it's not live action, but it's like photorealistic CGI of these animals, and it's very, very good. Like, on a technological standpoint, this movie is amazing, beautiful. Beautiful cinematography all across the board, and they recast some of the actors, of course, but like they did like keep James Earl Jones as Mufasa, and I love that. You know, I love James Earl Jones. So yeah, this movie also has like a few differences, like with the humor. Like, some of the meta humor in the movie was changed a little bit. There's like this one moment in like the original animated movie where Zazu is singing "It's a Small World" to Scar, which unfortunately is not in this version, but I rest my case. I mean, not everything that was in the original animated version is in this new one, like that moment I mentioned. And like, there are like a few changes to the humor, particularly with Timon and Pumbaa, and like, easily, I can't remember the name of the actors at the top of my head, but I love the actors that they chose to voice Timon and Pumbaa. I thought they did a pretty good job. You know, it took me a little while to get used to the actor voicing Timon, but I thought they were like the more memorable characters in the movie, so they're definitely the standouts. And then also, Donald Glover, he voiced adult Simba. I thought he was pretty good. You know, I know that the movie got a lot of criticism because of the fact that in real life lions don't necessarily smile. So they kind of like depicted that in the movie. So I mean, there was a lot of criticism for the movie for like the lions not really having emotions with the faces, and I think like their defense, like the creative team, was because of the fact that lions in real life don't really, you know, have actual, you know, emotional like expressions like apes do. But that didn't bother me though, because even in some of the more emotional moments of the movie, I still had that same impact of how I felt watching the original film. So I still had those emotions, even though the emotions of the characters didn't back up those moments. So I do still like, I am still invested with what's going on in the movie, and I do recognize that, you know, the flaw that a lot of people are having about the movie. But other than that though, I think it's a really good movie. It's definitely very underrated in my opinion. I think it's one of my favorite Disney live action remakes, honestly, because The Lion King is one of my favorite movies of all time, if I'm being honest. So and they just translated it into a kind of a live action film, but not really, because it's still an animated movie. It's just like photorealistic CGI with these animals. So I definitely do really like this movie. I mean, I do recognize some of the flaws that people have said about it, and I've noticed them myself, but they don't detract from my experience of watching the movie. So for my grade of The Lion King, I am going to give it an A-. Now moving on to Spider-Man Far From Home, which I've rewatched a couple times now. I've watched it like twice now. And, those post-credit scenes, oh my goodness, like, the one with J.K. Simmons reprising his role as J. Jonah Jameson, oh, I love the post-credit scenes in this movie, and also the one that teased Nick in space, in that space station, and teasing, like, the scrolls and what's to come for the future, with that, and also that WTF moment in that post-credit scene with J.K. Simmons, and the reveal that, you know, that Mysterio said. I am going to talk a few spoilers here and there, because the movie's been out for a few months now, and I'm not going to, like, talk about everything that happens in the movie, but I've kind of already mentioned, like, the big WTF moment in the post-credit scene, so. But yeah, it's definitely something that will, like, translate into future Spider-Man films, and it'll be interesting to see how Peter Parker deals with publicity in future films. So it's going to be interesting to see that going forward, and seeing how Peter's enemies will use that to their advantage going up against Spider-Man. So that's going to be interesting. And I really liked Jake Gyllenhaal as Mysterio. I thought he was really good in the role. The twist of where we saw him, you know, because we knew how that was coming, that Mysterio was the main villain of the movie. So there was that kind of deception that you're kind of expecting, but at the same time, you're kind of invested with how their relationship is kind of, you know, going forth throughout the first few acts of the movie, and then, you know, the Mysterio being the villain. And I thought it was really good. You know, I thought, once again, Tom Holland is easily my favorite new Spider-Man. I think he does an amazing job as Peter Parker, and also as Spider-Man. Because I feel like in the past, when we had Tobey Maguire, he was a really good Peter Parker, but he didn't quite nail the aspect of Spider-Man. Whereas with Andrew Garfield in the Amazing Spider-Man movies, he was not as good as Peter Parker, but he did a really good job as Spider-Man. Whereas with Tom Holland, he does an amazing job as Peter Parker and as Spider-Man. So, in my opinion, I think he's the most well-rounded of the few actors that have played that Spider-Man over the years, because he's done an amazing job portraying that more like a nerdy kind of teenage angst kind of version of Peter Parker, as well as the version of Spider-Man that Andrew Garfield did really great with in those movies. So once again, he was great, and also Zendaya had a much more prominent role in this movie than she did in the previous one, and you know, in Homecoming, she was great, and John Favreau was Happy once again, also really great, and there was like some humor with Happy and Aunt May. There was some kind of tension between those two characters a little bit in the movie. But they played it for humor, and I thought that was pretty good. Like for the most part, like I know like there are some elements of humor in Spider-Man: Far From Home that don't always land, but I appreciate it. You know, it's more of a high school, even though it's like taking place in the summer, it still had that elements of teenage high school kind of comedy, so it still has that going with it. So I do, like, I don't really feel like I relate to the high school version of Peter Parker that much anymore, because, you know, I'm in college now, you know, I'm an adult. I just still kind of gravitate towards like Tobey Maguire's version of Spider-Man a little bit more, because, you know, he wasn't in high school forever, and he was only in the high school for the first few acts of the first Spider-Man movie, and then Andrew Garfield, he got out of high school near the third act or so of Amazing Spider-Man 2. So I just don't really like relate to the high school version of Peter Parker that much anymore, because I'm an adult now. But I do enjoy it though. So that is like one kind of thing that I'm kind of in the middle about with Spider-Man Far From Home as well as Homecoming. But I do still enjoy it. You know, I enjoy the humor, and just overall pretty enjoyable movie, and not my favorite Spider-Man movie. I still think Spider-Man 2 by Sam Raimi is still my favorite Spider-Man movie, but I do think Far From Home is like a step above Homecoming. I do think it's a better film overall than Homecoming was. And yeah, that should be my review for Spider-Man Far From Home. My grade for that is probably a B+, though it's my grade for that movie. So yeah, that should do it for this video. I know it's been a while, and I'll try my best to not have such a big hiatus like I did. So I'm sorry about that, and I'll try to do another video hopefully this weekend, maybe tomorrow, maybe. So yeah, that should do it. Thank you all so much for watching. I'm so sorry for the long wait. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.